Good morning all. In the last session, we have discussed about the data identifiers, I mean the VHDL identifiers and data objects. So what are the VHDL identifiers? So identifiers are the user-defined words. They are used to name the objects in the VHDL. So it is used to name the signals, variables, constants, the data identifiers can also be used to name the entities, architectures, components, declarations, the procedures, functions, and for subprograms. To name all these, so we use the VHDL identifiers. So basically, there are two types of the VHDL identifiers. Basic identifiers and the extended identifiers. So what is the difference between the basic identifiers and the extended identifiers? So both are user-defined words, but the difference between the basic identifiers and the extended identifiers are, so the basic identifiers, so they will consist only the alphanumeric characters such as the uppercase and lowercase of the letters, and only a special symbol underscore is accepted. And the basic identifier is a case insensitive. So both uppercase letters and lowercase letters are acceptable as a combination of the user-defined word. Whereas in the extended identifiers, so the extended identifiers, a sequence of characters, they are placed, they are written between the two black slashes. So that is a basic extended identifier. And the extended identifier is a case sensitive. So the uppercase letters and lowercase letters are distinguished here. Okay. And the special symbols are allowed. So whatever the special symbols we use in the ASCII keyboard, so or in the ASCII, so all the special characters are allowed to use as a user defined word. So that is about identifiers. So two types of identifiers: basic identifiers, extended identifiers. And the another content which we have seen in our last class is VHDL data objects. So what is a data object? The data object holds a value or a range of values of a specified type. So simply, the objects are the things they use to hold the values. Objects are the things they hold the values or a value. And there are four classes of the data objects are there in VHDL. So what are they? The signal, variable, constant, and file. Signal, variable, constant, and file. So these are the classes of the data objects in the VHDL, right? And if you see the syntax of the data object will have the two things. One is class and the second is type. The class suggests the possible operations like a signal operation or variable operation or a constant or a file operation, class. Whereas the type, it provides or it specifies the legal values to that object here. So on which the operations will be performed. So in the last class, we have seen the signal, variable, and constant. So what is the difference between the signal, variable, and constant? So can you tell the difference between the signal, variable, and constant? So all the three data objects, the signal, variable, constant. So these three are the data variables. They are used to hold the values. But the difference between the signal, variable, and constant. So signal is a time variable function. So it is a time variable function. So according to the timing model, the signal will be changes its values. Whereas the variable, so it is not a time, it is not a function of time variable. So which means that you can assign the value at any time, and the value will be get updated. And the value will be get updated. Even in the running of the simulation also, you can change the value of variable so that the value of the variable will be updated. And the third one is constant data object. So in the constant data object, once the value is assigned to the constant object, so the data will not be modified or data cannot be changed till the simulation ends. So before the simulation, you can change the value, but during the simulation, during the runtime, you cannot change the value of a constant. So these are the difference between the signal variable and the constant. So now in this session, we will discuss about a file. So here the file is a special class of data object. The file is a special class of data object, and it serves as the interface between the VHDL program and the host environment. So actually we have four types of the data objects. The first three are used to hold the values. So they are comes under a generalized category of the data object. But now the file is the special class of the data object here. It is a special class of data object which serves as the interface. So it provides the interface between the VHDL programs and the host environment. So what do you mean this host environment? The host environment is nothing but our computer system. Because we run our VHDL programs in our computer. So therefore, there is a file, say text file. You all know what is a text file. So there is a text file and we want to access the text file in our VHDL program. So if we want to use the text file in our VHDL program, then there must be an interface which is support to read or write the contents of the text file in our VHDL program. So now the files, it is a special class of data object. So what is the function of the files? So what does the files do here? So the files is provide the interface between the VHDL programs and the host environment. So between the VHDL programs and to the computer. Okay. So this is the file. And there are some special operations can be performed on the files. So what functions we can perform on the files here? So the first operation is reading a file and second operation is a writing a file. So for what purpose we use the files in our VHDL program or in our VHDL is, so to write into a file or to read from a file. So example, you can take it as the text file. So from the text file, you can read the contents or you can write the contents into that text file. So here, in order to read and write the text file, or simply you can also understand as accessing. Files provides the accessing for the file which is in the host environment. So here, so the reading a file and writing a file are the basic operations of the file. So now the basic operation that need for reading and writing the files. So our files are in the external hard disk. Okay, the text file is in our external memory. It is in the hard disk. So now we want to access that text file from that external memory into our VHDL program. So now to accessing that, we need to perform the two operations, read operation and the write operation, right? So now in order to perform these two operations, read and write, what are the operations that are needed to perform the read operation and write operation? So they are declaration of a file type here. So the first thing we need to declare the file type. So what do you mean this file type here? Rightly I said that an example. Example, the file type is a text file, dot text file. Likewise, you will have the different types of the files in our computer. So in order to access those files, the first thing you need to specify the, or you need to declare the file type here, right? So this is the first operation in the file. And the second operation is declare a file here. After specifying the type of file, we have to declare the file, where it is, in which location it is there, in which drive it is there. So we need to specify the path for accessing that file. And the third operation, opening and closing a file of a specified type. So in the first step, you have specified or you will declare the file type. Example, I am saying, let us take the file is a .txt. So the .txt is nothing but a text file. You know what is a text file. And the second one is, after specifying the file type, we have to declare that file. So where exactly this .txt file is in the computer. And third one, after specifying the file name and the file file path location, so then either you can do two things here. One is opening a file, and second is a closing a file. Opening a file and closing a file. So this is the third function. And the fourth function is, once the file is opened, then what we can do? So we can either read from that file, or you can write into that file. Either you can read the content from the file, or you can write the content into that file here. So how we can understand this file here? The file is a special class of data object. Unlike a signal, variable and constant, here the file is a special class of data object. So what is the purpose or what is the function of the files? The files provides the interface. It provides the interface between the VHDL program and the host environment. And so what are the basic operations that are performed by the file? So the basic operations are reading a file and writing a file. So now, while you are performing a reading a file and writing a file, so we have to perform the four steps here again. What are they? The first one is you have to declare the file type. And the second one is you have to specify the way that file is in the computer. That is the declaration of file. And third one, after specifying the path, so the task is either to open that file or to close a file. And when it is opened, so when the file is opened, so now either we can read the content from that file, or you can write the content into that file. So these are the steps or the basic operations that are need for reading and writing files. What does the file do? It reading a file and writing a file. Simply file em chestundi, okati read chestundi ledha write chestundi. Kani read and write cheyalante manaki em kavali? Basic operations anevi unnai ikkada. Aa basic four operations enti ikkada? Declaration of a file, of a file type, declaration of file, opening and closing a file, reading and writing a file. So we will discuss these four operations in the file. So here the first one is the file type declaration. File type declaration. So while declaring a file, so we should ensure that the host environment correctly interprets the format of a data which is stored in that file. So which means that whether the file is a text file or or some other kind of file like a PDF or whatever it may be, different types of files are available. So we have to first specify the file type here. So the syntax of a file type declaration is, so this one. So here you can see this, the syntax. So what is the syntax here? So if you see here, type, file type name, type file type name is the file of type name. The file of type name. So an example, so see here, so how the file type can be declared here. See, the keyword is type and the file type name is what? Here he has given text file. So in our example, we consider that the file is a text file. So the type of the file, so which we are specifying in this example is text, is the file of the string here. File of the string. So this, so here it defines the a file type text that has a sequence of strings as a values in it here. So when you specify this text file, so there is some data in that file, so which is nothing but the sequence of the strings, so which have the values in it here. So simply to understand this, the file declaration. So what is the simple syntax here? You can observe here in the square box. So simple one, the type file type name is file of type name. అంటే ఇప్పుడు అది ఏ టైప్ అన్నది మనం చెప్తున్నాం, టెక్స్ట్ ఫైల్ అందుట్లో ఏముంటుంది, సో సీక్వెన్స్ ఆఫ్ స్ట్రింగ్స్ ఉంటున్నాయి అన్నది మనం అక్కడ చెప్తున్నాం, రైట్. సో దిస్ ఇస్ అన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, యూ కెన్ సీ హియర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, రైట్. సో దిస్ ఇస్ హౌ టు ద ఫైల్ టైప్ కెన్ బి డిక్లేర్డ్ ఇన్ ది ఫైల్స్. అండ్ ద సెకండ్ ఆపరేషన్, వాట్ ఈస్ ద సెకండ్ ఆపరేషన్? ద ఫస్ట్ ఆపరేషన్ ఇస్ డిక్లరేషన్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫైల్ టైప్, అండ్ ద సెకండ్ ఆపరేషన్ ఇస్ ఫైల్ డిక్లరేషన్. File declaration. So now, after declaring a particular type of file, here we can declare a file object. So the syntax of the file declaration is this one. See this one here, the file, file name, file type, open mode. So here the open mode refers the different types here, either it is a read mode or write mode or append mode. Three types of mode there. Is it string expression here? So this is the syntax for the file declaration, where exactly the file is located in our computer system. So we will see example here. See this one, the example here, see this example. So from the syntax, if you compare this, so file is a keyword, right? So what is the file name that we have given here? Input file. Input file. And the file type name, already in the file type declaration we have declared that it is a text file, right? In the first operation it is declared as a text file. So now the file type name is text. And if you observe here, there is a another one, open mode. So here this mode refers the three modes. One is a read mode, and the second mode is a write mode, and the third one is a append mode here. Append mode. Append mode. So either you can read the contents, or you can write the contents, or append. So append is also similar to of a write operation, but there is a difference here for the write and append. So write is usually we will write into that file. So in the append, so where the last line of the file at which the cursor will be there, and from that it starts writing the contents here, from which it starts writing the contents. So the second operation is the file declaration. So, and if you close, if you see this example, what this string expression says here, so the string expression, it says the path, location, where this text file is exactly in that computer system. So you can understand that one. See this one, physically in the host. So it specifies the path name to a physical file in the host environment. So you understand this. The first one is file type declaration, and the second operation is file declaration. In the file type declaration, you have specified the type of the file. It is a text file, example we consider. And in the second one, in the second operation, you are specifying the location of the file, and also you are specifying the type of the operation, whether it is a read operation or write operation, and there is an another operation, append. Append is nothing but a write operation. It just simply writes the contents into the file, but whereas here it is starts from the last line of that file. Okay, so this is this file declaration, second operation. And third one, what is the third operation? Opening and closing a file. So first you have to specify the type of the file, and the second one is you have to specify the where that file is located in the system. And third one, once if we have specified, then you have to instruct the program that whether the file has to be open or the file has to be closed. The file has to be either open or closed here. So it is necessary to open before using it and closing it after terminating. So ante ikkada meer observe chesthe meer oka file specify chestunnaru, meer ikkada oka file specify chesaru. So file specify chesinappudu meer em cheptunnaru, aithe read operation jaragali ledha write operation jaragali ani cheptunnam. So to do that task, either read operation or write operation, before that you have to tell that the either the file has to be open or the file has to be closed. If the contents are read, if the contents are read from the file, or if the contents are returned into the file, then we have to close that file here. So for that purpose, the opening and closing of a file is a necessary operation here. Okay, and here to open and to close the specified file, we use the procedures and functions in our VHDL program. So we use the procedures and functions. Actually, the procedures and functions are called as the subprograms. Remember this name, subprograms. They are called as the subprograms. You know what is a subprogram? So can you understand the term subprogram? Subprogram. Actually, a program is nothing but a group of instructions. They are written in a sequence, right? Whereas a subprogram, it is a small program. So where a limited number of instructions or a limited number of statements are written in a sequence to perform a specific task. So now in these subprograms, you will have two types in the subprograms. In the VHDL, you will have two types of the subprograms. What are they? Procedures and functions. So now to opening and closing a file, we use the procedures and functions to open and close a file. To open and close a file. So now, how to open a file here? How to open a file? So now, how to open a file here? So here you can see the procedure for to open a file after specifying the file location. So to open that file, so again we have a syntax here. So the syntax is procedure. So we will use procedures and functions in the opening and closing a file. So the procedure, it is a keyword, and then file open and file F1 file type name. So in this, if you see directly here, we have directly in this syntax, we have an example here. So file open, open the file. Ante man file open chestunnam. File open, and the type of the file is F1, and file type name. So in this, the file name is in string, and the open kind is in open kind. In file open kind read mode. So we can perform three types of operations: read operation, write operation, append operation. So now the file F1 that points the physical specified in the string file name with the specified mode, and the file open kind has a value of read mode here. Has a value of read mode. So a file can be opened. So you can see here, a file can be opened in three different modes: read mode, write mode, and append. So the difference between the write and append is the same. These two are the similar operations. The write will write the contents in that file, and append is also write the contents in that file, but it starts from the last line of the file. Okay, so in this example, in this syntax, so you can see that the file, how to open the file here. And the second one is to close the file here. So after open the file, after open the file, and after the performing the specific function, so then we have to close a specific file here. So now the syntax to close this file is procedure. See, procedure, file close. You can see the difference. File open, file close. And again, you have the same syntax here. See this, the file F1, file F1, file type name, file type name. So you will have the same procedure. The only difference is in the first one, you are opening a file, and in the second one, you are closing the file. And in between that, there is a function called the status to know the status of a open file. So now here you can see this, the opening and closing of a file here. The open and the closing of a file. So this shows the status. Ippudu meer, for example, oka file ni open chesaru. So a file open chestunnappudu ఆ టాస్క్ అనేది కంప్లీట్ అయిందా లేదా అనేది మనకు ఎలా తెలుస్తుంది అంటే స్టేటస్ ని బట్టి తెలుస్తుంది. అందుకని ఇక్కడ ఒక కమాండ్ ఉంది చూడండి, ప్రొసీజర్ ఫైల్ ఓపెన్ ఫైల్ స్టేటస్ అవుట్ ఫైల్ ఓపెన్ స్టేటస్. అంటే ఇక్కడ మీరు ఏం డిక్లేర్ చేస్తున్నారు ఈ సింటాక్స్ లో, మీరు ఏదైతే ఫైల్ ఓపెన్ చేయాలనుకుంటున్నారో ఆ ఫైల్ అన్నది ప్రాపర్ గా ఓపెన్ అయ్యిందా లేదా అనేది దాని యొక్క స్టేటస్ అనేది ఇక్కడ మీరు చెక్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. ఎట్లాగా? బై యూజింగ్ దిస్ సింటాక్స్, బై యూజింగ్ దిస్ సింటాక్స్. సో హియర్ యు కెన్ సీ దిస్, ద సేమ్ థింగ్ యూ హ్యావ్ హియర్ ఇన్ ద ప్రొసీజర్, వాట్ ఎవర్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఇన్ యువర్ ఓపెన్ ఎ ఫైల్, ద సేమ్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఇన్ దిస్ ఆల్సో. బట్ సో హియర్ దిస్ ఫైల్ ఓపెన్ స్టేటస్ హ్యావ్ ఎ రిటర్న్ వాల్యూ బై దిస్ ప్రొసీజర్, బై ఎగ్జిక్యూటింగ్ దిస్ ప్రొసీజర్, by executing these instructions, I mean these statements, by executing these statements, okay, so it return a value here. The value is any one of either four here. So here you have four options. If the value is open, okay, so which specifies that, which mentions that the file open operation was successfully. If the file is successfully opened, so it will return a value open okay. Suppose if already a file is opened, attempted to open an already open file, already open in a file and open chestunnaru ankonni meer appudu em cheptunnadi, status error ani cheptundi eppudu ee program ni meer run chesinappudu. And the next one, name error, file not found or not accessible. So you have specified a text file with a name, and if that file name, if the file with that name is not available in that memory, so then it gives a return value name error, file not found. And the last one is mode error, the file cannot be opened in this mode. So these are the status return values when you execute this procedure. If you execute this procedure, it will return a value here. So that is, it is one of the four here, any one of the from this four. So this is how to open and close a file. And what is the last one? The first one is you have to specify the type of file, and the second one is you have to specify the file path location, and third one is you have to either open or to close that file. And once if the file is open, then you have to specify whether it is a read operation or a write operation here. So the last operation is reading and writing files, reading and writing files. So the need functions and procedures to read and write files to declare the type here. ఇక్కడ మీరు అబ్జర్వ్ చేశారా, ఇంత ముందు ఉన్న థర్డ్ స్టెప్ లోను ఇప్పుడున్న ఫోర్త్ ఆపరేషన్ లో కూడా మీరు ఏమి ఉపయోగిస్తున్నారు? ఫంక్షన్స్ అండ్ ప్రొసీజర్స్ ని యూజ్ చేస్తున్నారు. అంటే ఫంక్షన్స్ అండ్ ప్రొసీజర్స్ అంటే ఏంటి ఇక్కడ? దే ఆర్ నథింగ్ బట్ సబ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్, సబ్ రొటీన్స్. ఓకే, సబ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్. సో దేనికోసం ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ చేస్తున్నాం మనం సబ్ ప్రోగ్రామ్స్ ని ఎయిదర్ టు రీడ్ ద డేటా ఆర్ టు రైట్ ద డేటా ఫ్రమ్ ది స్పెసిఫైడ్ ఫైల్ ఓకే సో ప్రొసీజర్స్ రీడ్ అండ్ రైట్ ఆర్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ది ఐఓ ఆపరేషన్స్ సో ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు కమ్యూనికేట్ విత్ ది పెరిఫెరల్ డివైసెస్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు కమ్యూనికేట్ విత్ ద మెమరీ సో వి యూజ్ ది ప్రొసీజర్స్ ఎయిదర్ టు రీడ్ అండ్ రైట్ ది ఆపరేషన్స్ హియర్
పవర్ పోతే రాదుగా లేదు మీదే పెట్టండి ఆగండి సార్ మా ఊరికి మెసేజ్ పెట్టాలి ఆగండి
మెసేజ్ అక్కర్లేదు కనెక్ట్ చేయండి వెంటనే డేటా హాట్స్పాట్ ఆన్ చేయండి అక్కర్లేదు రికార్డింగ్ పోదు మళ్ళీ ఆఫ్ చేస్తుంది ఆఫ్ చేయొద్దు అది అట్లానే ఉంచండి దీనిలో వైట్ డేటా ఆన్ చేసి హాట్స్పాట్ ఆన్ చేయండి త్వరగా రీకనెక్ట్ అయ్యి
స్క్రీన్ షేర్ అవుతుందా
అవుతుంది సార్
ఓకే అంటే పవర్ కట్ వచ్చిందమ్మ ఇక్కడ అందుకని మీకు అది వాయిస్ అది వినబడుతుందా ఓకే తల్లి ఓకే So here you can see the procedures for the read and write operation. So you can see the procedures for the read and write operations. You can see the procedure here for read operation and the procedure for the write operation. And there is a function you see in this program, in this code, in this VHDL code, if you see, a procedure is there and as well as a function is also there. So the procedure and function they perform a similar kind of operation. So they will execute the subprograms. But here the procedure, it is using for to reading and writing the data. So either to read the data from the output or write the data into the input. So input in the sense from the external device or point of view. And finally here the function end file. So now this function file, it checks the last line of the program. It checks the last line in that specified text file. If it comes to end of that file, then the program will be now terminated here. It will be terminated, and once if the procedure and functions are performed once, so they will return with a boolean value here. The boolean value either the true or false. If it is successfully returned or if it is successfully done the operation, so it will return with a boolean value true. If not, it will return with a boolean value false. But here you can understand that. So the procedure is a subprogram. The function is a subprogram, and the procedures are used here to read the data from the specified text file or whatever may be the file you will specify. So it reads the content from that file, and the second procedure is to write the contents into that file. And finally, the function, what does this function do? So here the function, it checks the last line of the program. I mean that file. The last line of that file, if it comes to end of that file, so then it will come out from this function output. Otherwise it will keep on executing the file, and once the procedure and functions are done, so they will return with a value like your subprograms. So in subprograms, actually we will write a group of statements separately. And once if that subprogram is executed, then it will be back to its main program. So similarly here also, the procedures are for to read and write the contents from the specified file. And once if the function is done, so then it will be back to its the main location here. So these are all the operations for the reading and writing of a file. So do you understand this? Am I doing that?
Yes, sir.
So the data objects are very very important. VHDL identifiers. ఎక్కువగా అది ఏంటంటే షార్ట్ ఆన్సర్స్ కి అడుగుతాడు డేటా ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ అనేవి ఎస్ఏ క్వశ్చన్స్ కి అడుగుతాడు అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ డేటా టైప్స్ హియర్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ డేటా టైప్స్ సో వి విల్ డిస్కస్ ది డేటా టైప్స్ ఇన్ అవర్ నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్ బట్ వాట్ ఆర్ ది డేటా టైప్స్ ఇన్ ది విహెచ్డిఎల్ హియర్ సో ది డేటా టైప్స్ ఆర్ నథింగ్ బట్ సో హియర్ ఈచ్ డేటా ఆబ్జెక్ట్ Each data object has a type associated with it. So we have seen that a data object have a class and a data object have a type. Class is four classes. In the four classes, one data objects so signal, variable, constant, and file. But type వచ్చేది అప్పటికి ఏమవుతుంది? ఇక్కడ ఈ డేటా ఆబ్జెక్ట్స్ ఏం చేస్తున్నాయి మనకి దే హోల్డ్ ది వాల్యూస్ హియర్ అంటే మీరు ఏదైతే చెప్తున్నారో సిగ్నల్ అన్నారు అనుకోండి సిగ్నల్ కి ఒక వాల్యూని హోల్డ్ చేస్తుంది అదే మీరు వేరియబుల్ అన్నారు అనుకోండి ఇట్ విల్ హోల్డ్ ఎ వాల్యూ టు దట్ వేరియబుల్ కాన్స్టెంట్ అన్నారు అనుకోండి దానికి కూడా అది ఒక వాల్యూని హోల్డ్ చేస్తుంది కదా కానీ అది హోల్డ్ చేసే వాల్యూ అన్నది లీగల్ వాల్యూనా ఇల్లీగల్ వాల్యూనా అన్నది కూడా మనకి ఇంపార్టెంట్ So the legal and illegal values are specified by the type of the data. So in the next class, we will discuss the data types, VHDL data types. So here we have four data types here, like the classes of the data objects. Here we have the four classes of the data types in VHDL. I'm just giving outline. The scalar types. Composite types, access types, and files. So in this type also we have the file class. Okay, so for the data objects and for data types, the file is same. కాబట్టి మనం file గురించి మనం extraగా ఏమి further గా discuss చేయం. So in the next class we will see the what are the different types of VHDL data types. Okay, na? No?